Scorpio 2021. Now, Scorpios are going to have a year that's heavily focused on home and family life, as well as relationships, partnerships, business partnerships, possibly even creativity or children. Now, 2021 is really the year of the fixed signs. So you are getting the focus this year, and that's not necessarily good or bad, but your relationships are highlighted. There is a lot of growth going on, a lot of abundance and creativity and changes on the home front that you should be experiencing and can expect. There can even be new things that you're starting to work out in your career or finances as well. My name is Desiree with theastrologyaddiction.com, and thank you so much for watching. Today's video is specifically for Scorpio risings, but you can definitely watch this if you have your sun or your moon in Scorpio. Now stay tuned till the end, and I'll be sharing a video with you guys on the Great Conjunction, which is Jupiter and Saturn in Aquarius, which is your fourth house of home and family life, and how this is going to be affecting you. Please also leave your feedback for how 2020 was for you and your experience, and let me know your goals and ambitions for 2021. Please also like this video, subscribe to my channel, and leave your feedback below. So we start off January 2021 with Mars ingressing into Taurus, which is your seventh house of relationships, partnerships, and possibly marriage or business partnerships. Now on the 8th, Mercury in Aquarius will be squaring Mars, and Mercury is conjoining Jupiter at the same time. So what that means for you is that there can be some news or new information in your relationships or family life that is a bit shocking and kind of sharp, or feel like maybe you're being attacked in some way. You know, like there's just a lot of overwhelming things and news that you're learning about. On the 13th, Mars squares Saturn, which definitely brings in a tense dynamic between your home life and your relationships. On the 17th, Uranus squares Jupiter, bringing in some like unexpected or explosive energy in your home life and family life. And I could see this being like a shocking opportunity, maybe something that is affecting where you live, maybe an opportunity to move to meet a new business partner or a new relationship partner. Now, Mercury goes retrograde on January 30th in your fourth house of Aquarius. And this is something to keep in mind. I wouldn't recommend maybe signing any contracts about where you want to live between January 30th and February 20th when Mercury goes direct. There can just be some miscommunication on the home front around that time, or some things maybe falling through the cracks that you definitely want to be cautious of. And with Mars, you know, so closely conjunct to Uranus in Taurus in your seventh house, this can bring in some unexpected drama and fights, or, you know, tension and frustration in your intimate relationships. Now, February, there is a strong stellium starting to build up in Aquarius with Venus. Venus enters Aquarius February 1st. So Venus, Saturn, Jupiter, the Sun, and Mercury retrograde are all, you know, piled up in that fourth house of yours of Aquarius. So it's really time to settle in and kind of focus on the things around your house with your family that need attention, possibly. And, you know, maybe there's been things that have been neglected or not really kept up to date within your home life in some way. And this is very closely tied to your marriage partnerships or your business partnerships. I could see it being like you're, you know, just starting kind of anew and fresh in the home life in some way with your relationship partner, maybe moving in with someone new. Maybe you're working from home and have some new business relationships that are causing you some tension, or that you're learning a lot from. But the first Saturn and Uranus square is on February 17th, which kind of brings in some boundaries. Like you're learning about how to set boundaries in your home life for when unexpected things come up. You're learning about flexibility as well, and being more changeable and adaptable to your home life surroundings or your relationship partner. Now, Venus enters Pisces on February 25th, which is your fifth house of children and creativity. So you can have some new themes of children coming up for you. It can bring in, you know, some very good positive energy around that, maybe creativity or romantically even. You can be having some benefic, positive, and hopeful energy that's starting to kind of culminate for you around that time. Now, March 26th, Venus and the Sun are conjunct in Aries, which is your sixth house of employees and service. So you can feel maybe a bit of contention, or, you know, there's some even level of like confusion about how you can help someone or serve someone in your life, or even maybe confusion with how you are dealing with employees that you have. Whenever Venus is under the beams of the Sun, it's not, you know, you're not able to see her. So there's kind of this highlight on service and on even your health, but there's something missing that's kind of causing confusion that you can't really find that clarity that you're looking for. Venus enters Taurus on February 14th, which is your seventh house, bringing in some really good, positive, hopeful energy with your relationships and good connectivity there. Maybe some peace is starting to come from the last few months of kind of unexpected craziness that you have been juggling. And there's kind of a feeling of like abundance by the end of April, where you are having a lot of joy in your relationships or partnerships. Maybe you're meeting a new relationship partner or just starting to get more like physical with someone even. May 13th is also important because Jupiter will be entering Pisces, and that is your fifth house of children, creativity. So again, brings in those themes of children or sexuality, romance. There can be some really positive, growth-oriented things going on for you there. You can be feeling very creative and very, I think, hopeful overall. Now, July 24th, we have a full moon in Aquarius, opposite to that Leo sun, and Mars is still in Leo. So there's some kind of cleansing or lesson that you're starting to learn, or something coming to culmination around your home and family life. There can maybe even be some roadblocks as the moon approaches Saturn retrograde in Aquarius that maybe are holding you back, like something in your home life that maybe is holding you back from a career achievement or vice versa. And this is kind of coming to a point at that time. August 2021, we have a similar energy going on with the sun conjoining Mercury in Leo and then opposing Saturn in Aquarius. There's some new information or messages that you're learning about within your career, opportunities even that are coming about, but you do definitely have to consider the boundaries and limitations that are still in your home, you know, life in some way, or even just in your lineage, you know, your thought process about home. You're kind of learning to expand and maybe become a little bit more flexible and changeable, adaptable to juggle home and work life. Now, Mercury goes retrograde on January 30th in your fourth house of Aquarius, and this is something to keep in mind. I wouldn't recommend maybe signing any contracts about where you want to live between January 30th and February 20th when Mercury goes direct. There can just be some miscommunication on the home front around that time, or some things maybe falling through the cracks that you definitely want to be cautious of. And with Mars, you know, so closely conjunct to Uranus in Taurus in your seventh house, this can bring in some unexpected drama and fights, or, you know, tension and frustration in your intimate relationships. Now, October 23rd, the sun enters Scorpio, and then October 30th, Mars enters Scorpio. Mars is applying to this square to Saturn in your fourth house and activating that T-square with Uranus in your seventh house. So November is not really the easiest month for anyone, and especially you. There can be something, you know, that stirs up your relationships or your home life. Maybe some fights, arguments, nasty words even, or unpredictable, you know, unexpected things in your relationships. Definitely want to keep an eye out for your health as well. As Mars goes through your fifth house, you can be more accident prone, especially since it's applying to that opposition to Uranus in your seventh house, and really builds up the contention with you and a relationship or business partnership at this time. November 19th, there is a lunar eclipse in Taurus. So this is further just deepening into that relationship dynamic, whatever you're personally going through in this month, and kind of makes things a little bit foggy for you. You know, not the decision maybe that you have to make, or, you know, argument you're being faced with isn't as clear as you would like it to be. December, we have the final Saturn square to Uranus on December 24th, which unfortunately is Christmas Day and brings up possibly a, you know, another unexpected thing going on with your home life that is tied into your relationship somehow. Intimate partnerships are the main theme for you this year, and there's going to be a lot of unexpected things, things that you have to adapt to and adjust to, and, you know, maybe learn how to accept other people's boundaries, accept your own boundaries, and, you know, really be flexible. December 28th, Jupiter enters Pisces, your fifth house, which finally is going to bring in, you know, some really easy, more lightweight and growth-oriented energy for you, especially around creativity, children, or new romances in your life. So I hope you enjoy this video of Scorpio for 2021. Now on the screen, we have the Jupiter and Saturn conjunction, the great conjunction for 2020 that we just had in December. And check this out to see how this is affecting your fourth house of Aquarius. If you're interested in booking a reading with me, my link is in the description box. And thanks again for watching. Have a great day. Bye.